time now for an update from Fox Carolina News and Fox Carolina Weather. Weather rates certified most accurate.
A good Friday afternoon. Hope you're enjoying the sunshine. We definitely deserve it after the last 24 hours of storms. Let's head to foxcarolina.com right now, but you can see our big story. More storms headed our way this weekend, so we'll check in with Chief Meteorologist Kendra Kent in just a moment on that. We should mention we are in Lawrence County, where the National Weather Service is surveying some damage in Hickory Tavern that could turn out to be a possible weak tornado. We'll have that as soon as we get confirmation from the National Weather Service coming up at 4, 5, and 6 this evening. Well, here's a bizarre story you don't hear much about. How about stealing an ambulance? Yeah, most people don't do that, but this guy is accused of doing it last night just before midnight in Anderson County. His name, Scotty Yergin. So we're told from MedShore that they were responding to a 911 call there in Anderson County. When they got to the apartment complex, they touched base with a patient as the second paramedic was coming out of the ambulance to meet the other paramedic. That's when they saw this gentleman get inside the ambulance and take off. We're told the lights were not on. And after a brief chase with the Anderson County Sheriff's Office, Mr. Scotty Yergin was pulled over and taken to jail. Good news is nobody was hurt, so that's the plus news here. But again, Mr. Yergin now is in jail, facing several charges, including grand larceny, DUI, and failure to stop for blue lights. So we've been following that very closely this afternoon. And I was trying to find out, I think it was the Allison Square apartment. It's not mentioned here on our website, but I believe that is where it happened. We'll have much more on this coming up this afternoon as well. Some other stories we are watching this afternoon here at Fox Carolina. Of course, the weather, our top story. Expect some traffic delays, though, out on I-35 due to the Gateway Project in the coming days. So be mindful of that. And we're also tracking the COVID-19 vaccine. Don't forget the governor announcing today that all South Carolinians ages 16 and up will be eligible to get a COVID-19 shot. You can start registering to get your shot if you're 16 and older next week on Wednesday, and then all eligibility will begin on March 31st. That's some good news, and we have an entire section as we track the vaccine here, breaking down those numbers at foxcarolina.com. Well, I'll tell you, it shows 82 degrees on our website right now. The sun is out, and man, is it muggy out there.
It really is, and that's going to set the stage for more showers and storms as we go into this weekend. Right now, Saturday does not look like a big severe weather day. We'll have to watch for a few storms up in western North Carolina late in the day. Showers, though, in the upstate, so won't be dry. And then stronger storms are expected Sunday as a cold front moves in. It's going to bring a line of storms. There will be a low-end tornado threat, but right now it looks like damaging wind and hail along that line will be a greater concern. Sunday's timing looks to be noon to 6 p.m., but that may be fine-tuned as we get a little bit closer. You can see the threat on Saturday. It's very low wind just for the mountains, but then as we go into the day on Sunday, it increases to level 2 or slight risk for areas, pretty much the entire viewing area and all of North Carolina just about. So it's going to be a busy weather day. We'll keep you posted on those storms. Of course, you'll want to tune in on the 4, 5, and 6 o'clock newscast this evening and on the 10 o'clock news tonight and throughout your weekend.